I think with adulting, people get really serious about their schedules and stuff, that you cannot move your office time or you cannot move your social interaction time. I feel like so scheduling is very important.
Hi guys, this is Gaurav, aka The Social Dancer, and with me is my friend and someone who I've met very, very recently, about 4 or 5 months back, at the multiple Latin festivals around the country. Hi, I'm Rinmoy.
Hi.
So on this bite, what we're taking from Rinmoy is, what does she do professionally?
Well, so I'm in research. I'm doing my PhD right now, and otherwise I'm doing research projects on the side. It's in the field of education. I work with government schools, and currently I'm looking at gender justice in school culture. So yeah.
Nice. So that's been your full-time profession?
Yes, that's my full-time profession. That's pretty intense.
Right. So I must say, I mean, if you guys can see the video in the background, that definitely does not look like she's into a full-time profession or what she said she does. So how do you find time for dancing? How did dance come into your life? And when did it happen? If you could just like summarize it, I know it's a very big thing, but if you could summarize it in like 2 or 3 lines as to how your journey started with dance.
So I come from a Bengali middle class family where you always have some kind of music dance going on. So I think we've always had that in the background. But for Latin dancing especially, it's a little bit of classes and nightlife oriented and stuff. So I have completely shifted my schedules to do this, because the first time I saw this dance form in say 2018, I was obsessed. I'm like, okay, I need to learn this. So I just jumped right in. I didn't think twice. So if that makes me do, you know, night shifts and everything, I do that so that I'm able to dance like I want to. Yeah.
Things you do for your passion. Yeah, I mean, it's something that, you know, that you gotta take out time for your passion. Yeah. She's into another full-time profession is what I'm trying to say. And the way you gotta do for your passion, things you gotta do is what she's trying to say. So, I mean, if there is something that you'd like to tell the people who are in the field of research and, you know, taking out their time where about 12 hours of their day is going into something else and they feel they want to start dancing,
yeah,
what would be the tip that you would give to them? You know, I mean, whether it's the working females or it's working males all around us in their professional fields, what's the advice that you'd give to them?
I think with adulting, people get really serious about their schedules and stuff, that you cannot move your office time or you cannot move your social interaction time. I feel like so scheduling is very important. Like, you have to always make sure that no matter what you do, you're able to take out that 2 hours or 1 hour a day or 3 times a week, and do it like workout if you are going to the gym or something. So which means you have some amount of discipline. I'm hoping people can manage that. If you can manage 3 times a week, I think you've got it.
Nice. I think that's a serious, I mean, a very enlightening piece of insight there, that even if you take out 3 times a week, some amount of time towards, you know, what you really love doing, with some scheduling and some discipline, as she rightly said. So that really plays out to be very beneficial. So, I mean, that could be something that you can carry away with this bite. And I hope everyone starts their journey with dancing in some way or the other. This is The Social Dancer signing out.